your drawing, building, you know where your shadow's gonna be and everything, you could choose to paint. So if you're choosing to paint, then you're going to need to mix your skin color. As you can see from my little chart that I made, there are a bunch of different skin colors and ways that you can make it. So I created this little chart right here. I've got yellow ochre and burnt and deep crimson. This is yellow ochre, deep crimson, burnt sienna. This is yellow ochre with not very as much deep crimson as up here. So you can kind of tell from this, there are a bunch of different ways that you can go about doing this, and you can use this as a starting off point for how you should mix your color. So once you've identified that, you know, okay, I think my skin color is maybe like in here, then you can go to your palette and you can start mixing your color. You've got this top part of your palette here that you can just drag some color over to, so you can mix there and not mess up your colors over here. So right now I've got some deep crimson and burnt sienna happening. You have this whole outside edge, so you can test out a color to see if it is right. You can test it out again, thin it out, see if maybe that's a little bit better. You can add some of another color to it, see if that's a little bit better, until you get your color that you think is what you need. Alright, so I think I'm going with a really thinned out yellow ochre, deep crimson, and burnt sienna. Alright, so, before you actually start painting though, you want to kind of erase away some of your shadow that you've got going on, so that it doesn't make your painting look really muddy. Alright, so, now that I've got my color that I'm pretty sure is going to work for me, I'm going to paint in my skin color. I'm really not going to worry too much about getting it in my hair area or whatever, because I know I'm going to cover that up. I just want to make sure that I'm careful around my eyes and my lips. Then I can go into other parts of my painting. I'm going to let that dry before I put my shadow down. So I'm going to go into my background and I'm going to cover that. Just make sure that your brush strokes are even and consistent. And again, you don't have to worry about like going over your hair, for example, because you're going to add your hair in and that'll cover all of that up. I'm gonna go into my face and I'm gonna add some shadow. You want to be kind of careful with that. I would go with a thin paintbrush for adding your shadow. But I'm basically just gonna add some burnt sienna to the skin color that I mixed before. I'm gonna go in and add my shadow that way. And if you feel like it looks too dark, you can always add a little bit more water to kind of thin it out a little bit. But I will say it's hard to take stuff away once it's there. So have a light hand and remember you can always add more if you don't have enough. And your painting will start to work a little bit. Don't freak out. This paper is made to be painted on, it'll be fine. Unless you're painting the same spot over and over and over again, you're probably not going to paint a hole into it. Don't take that as a challenge. Now, we've got some shadow in there. Let's start adding in. Unfortunately, not painting it, sometimes it looks real weird until it looks right. My only advice there is just keep going. And don't expect it to be perfect, because that almost never happens. Alright, there's my hair. I'm gonna add some eyebrow. Now my skin's a little bit drier.
Thank you.